Next question is from Daniel Past 98. Do box squats hold value over traditional back squats, and would there be a reason to add them into a program if the overall goal was improving leg definition and size?
I learned about box squats, or at least I applied box squats to my routine later on in my workout routine. Never did them up until I'd say I got to my 30s. And, you know, studying powerlifters, I said to myself, you know, why don't I do some of these, you know, what are considered powerlifting only movements? Even though I'm not going to compete in powerlifting, maybe they have some carryover for muscle development. And, you know, if they do them, there must be some value. So I included them in my routine and I had huge gains from the box squats. Huge. Yeah. Now, for those of you who don't know what they are, a box squat, literally you have a box or a bench behind you. You back up with the barbell. You sit down, controlled. You don't want to plop down. You want to sit down, controlled. Pause on the bench or the box, almost like you're just sitting on it for a second.
Maintain, just cut all momentum.
Maintain tightness, and then come back up. So here's what happens. Here's where the value, I think, comes from the box squats. When you're lowering a weight and then you reverse direction and come back up, there's some energy that's stored in the muscle as it lengthens that you then get on the rebound on the way up. Mm-hmm. With the box, you stop at the bottom and remove that. So you're not going to be able to squat as much. Your muscles have to generate force almost like a dead stop. Not quite, because you lowered yourself on the box, but almost like a dead stop.
Yeah, there's no recoil kinetic energy that kind of springs you back up.
Totally. So you get great gains from doing this. It's different. You build more muscle. Now, I love also using box squats with my clients because it helps teach clients how to squat better.
Yeah, with depth.
Absolutely. I would put a box underneath somebody and I'd have them focus on perfect form, and the box was there to catch them if they lost their balance, and then they'd slowly sit down and then stand back up. It was one of my favorite tools for teaching people how to squat. I ended up using it all the time.
Yeah, I totally agree. I actually came across box squats pretty much in the same time frame as chains and bands and kind of these extra tools that really help you to kind of isolate the different components of the squat. And you know, powerlifters were using these concepts, and I kind of got into it. And it was crazy the amount of strength that doing box squats really helped you to kind of address the biggest sticking point of the lift, which is at the very bottom of your squat. And to gain strength there is very helpful.
I also found, I know you mentioned, both you did mention, you know, the inability to use the rebound effect or kinetic energy, right? But I also, and so having to go a little bit lighter because of that. But I also found that this helped a lot with clients to break through like a mental plateau of loading the bar more. Mm. Because you had this seat to fall back on.
Totally.
And that safety kind of net was there.
Psychologically, yeah.
Yeah, psychologically it would help you sometimes load. I remember this for myself. Mm. I remember the very first time I ever put three plates back when I was, you know, in my mid-20s. Like, that just seemed so unbelievably heavy when 225 was heavy for me back then. And I remember lifting with these guys and them being like, we'll do box squats and I'll be there to spot you. And I'm like, I can barely do 225. I don't want to do 315. He's like, I just want you to feel the weight. But I remember after I did that, how much control and strength I felt with 225. And so I've seen it used like that. And I believe some of the strategy that they use over at what's the famous power?
West Side
Barbell, yeah. Right? I mean, they're huge advocates of box squats. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think that's part of every routine there. So even though a lot of times you have to go lighter because you don't have the rebound effect, sometimes the opposite is true. Sometimes I had clients or people that would feel stronger or feel safer because they had a box underneath, and that allowed them to actually increase the weight. And then when they then pulled the box, they were able to control more weight.
Right. Now, the way you program this, it can be programmed obviously on leg day. It could be your squat workout can be all box squats. Or the way I like to use it, and the way I programmed it in MAPS Anabolic, is I like to do a few sets of box squats before regular barbell squats. I found that to be a great place to put it in the workout.